Yo, 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 what up, everybody? What's going on? Welcome to Mario Esco Live. We're going to switch this up. Start that first. I am your host, Mario Esco, and alongside me is my good friend, co-host, Gil Vargas.
What up, Gil?
What's going on, brother, man?
I'm trying to get my earpiece so I can hear everything you're saying.
We are totally not equipped. And ready to rock, I guess.
Nah, man. I was mid-sip coffee, and then you were like, right, what up? We are live. I'm like, that just happened.
Are we even a little late? What time is it?
We are definitely late.
How late are we?
8 minutes.
Oh, thank God we don't have a producer.
Hey.
Yeah.
Because if we did.
Go ahead. Yeah.
We'd be more professional. But we don't. Therefore, please excuse our, mistakes.
Well,
please.
Without a producer, I'm kind of producer right now, right?
You are. So technically, you're disrespecting yourself.
And we would be professional.
So let's start this conversation.
If we had a real producer, Mario. Wow. Thanks, bro. You know what? We would be more professional
if we actually had real production.
All in front of everybody and whoever's here. I don't know.
Ali oxen free.
I love it. No special guests. I know. I will eventually start reaching out for special guests again.
Yeah.
I don't know. Been going through some trials personally, and some growth in a good way.
Well, it feels kind of weird. You got COVID, you got all these political things that are happening, and you're like, man, we should get an artist for next week. But it kind of makes it a little bit
Yeah.
And should I be?
I got to introduce everything, but that's good topic to discuss about how should you be responding during this time right now? Like, should you just be like,
I could tell you right now, when we come back to this, I'm not going to have a clear answer because I don't think anybody does.
Okay. All right. Cool. I like that. Maybe it's like some kind of like cultural trauma we're all experiencing at the same time.
Everybody's coping in their own different ways. Attaching themselves to a organization. I mean, we'll talk about it.
Yeah, dope. Yeah. I'm sorry. I gotta try to follow the chat. I'm trying to get myself situated. My bad. I don't even see the chat. I'm putting it up right now for everybody. Just bear with me real quick. I'm getting in the chat room now. What up, everybody? What's going on? I see everybody up in here. What's going on, everybody? I don't know if you guys were already talking to me and chatting before. It comes up as I come on. So if there was discussions before it, I probably won't see it. So say what's up. What up, people? So yeah, man. Let's jump back to that, man. Let's jump back to that. So what do we do normally?
Are you done with your announcer?
No special guests. No, not yet. Not yet. Okay. Hold up.
Dang, bro.
Yo, I'm out of it today.
You need a little oil in them juice.
Yo, shout out to our people. Shout out to our people, man, and our listeners. GH3 Radio, we love you. 520 Radio, Godify, The Bridge Radio. Our YouTubers, what's up, our YouTubers, Facebookers. Is that how you call them, Facebookers? That's how I call them. Man. My Facebookers, my YouTubers.
Sounds harsh.
Yo, my Facebookers, please jump over to my YouTube and subscribe to the YouTube as well. Let me get it up there. Look up on the screen. Boom, it looks like that. The red Mario Esco, you see the logo there. Go make sure to subscribe to our YouTube. Shout out to our Twitch followers. We love y'all. The Unashamed Network audience, we love y'all. To our podcasters, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts. Wherever you listen, we appreciate y'all too.
For real.
Let me cut this off.
We love y'all.
Check out d2lproductions.com. We got new merch available there. I got my song Feeling Like Grass available there as well. Gil, actually, can you go? Actually, I'll grab it. Hold on one second. I'm going to grab something real quick. The shirts right there on the couch. You see them? The white shirts?
Oh, yeah.
Can you go grab those for me real quick?
Yeah.
So Gil's going to go grab the new shirts that are available on the website as well on d2lproductions.com. It does take a little bit. There's a delay for the shirts. So just to give you a heads up, if you guys are thinking about ordering a shirt, but you do get the song with it, download and the lyrics as well. You know, just something saying thank you. That's what's up for showing your support. And they look like this. Now this is one of them. It's the white and green. We have black, gray, dark gray, brown, some other colors, and we also got hats to go with it. So, yeah. Go check that out. D2Lproductions.com. I don't know what my co-host is doing right now. I have no idea.
My cord was all janked up on the chair, man. I had to do what it do. Because I need to be comfortable.
As I'm trying to give
I'm
you guys
I'm fighting this cord. Y'all don't see me. All y'all I hear feel is boom. Me. But this cord right here was choked.
Things are falling. Like, things are getting spilled. Gil's getting
like,
choked out.
This thing
out.
Is after me. Like, I'm just trying
yo,
to listen,
Busy,
bro.
What up? What up? What up? What's going on, man?
I'm
love you, bro.
Just trying to listen.
Yo, share the show as you guys jump in. That's what's up. We love you. So go check it out, man. Shout out to... Yeah. What's his name, Gil?
What's his name?
Jahil? Jahil
Oh, Baez? The dancers, yes.
Shout out to our brother there.
Jahil Baez.
He did a dance to the song too. So I'm gonna give a quick sneak peek since you guys are with me here. Let's play it real quick.
All the flesh is like grass, and all its glory like the flower of grass.
Super dope.
The grass.
Yeah, man.
Dude did his thing, man. Gil feels kind of different about it. Gil's like, yo, I think he could have killed it a little bit. He could have came with it a little bit more harder, you know, on certain parts and whatnot.
Yeah.
Gil, you think you can do better than this dude or what? Like, yo, you think you can do better than the old boy? This dude got skills, man. This is what he does. Come on, man. Don't be shy about it. Talk about it. What do you think?
I don't think I would do better.
Yo, you're an old man.
I would do my version.
You'll be hurting right there.
I would do my version.
What would you do? Some kind of like grown man?
You
like,
know.
You go out there with like a...
Yeah.
Look at homeboy. He's killing it, bro. You can't... Bow,
no, he's nice.
Bow.
That's what I'm saying. He's nice.
What style is this anyway? You know
he's,
what kind
he's of... He's doing a little bit of a mixture, like crumping, some taking.
Okay. So what's that right there?
Bang.
Woo! That wasn't fire? Come on. You didn't like that?
I would have done without the blur.
That was my blur. I don't.
Hey man, I didn't know that. I'm just saying the blur was it was too blurry.
You're foul,
need to
bro.
Blur that out.
You're foul. This dude killed it, man. Shout out to how you pronounce that, brother?
I think it's Jahil.
Jahil.
Oh, Jahil.
Jahil. Is that how you say it?
It could be.
Jahil.
I feel
his name is right there. His name is right there up on the screen. Dude's killing it. He has videos of himself doing dances to other songs as well. Reach out to him, man. He's a dope artist.
He's probably like
killing it.
First time somebody
I seen
said
the
my
first
name
thing
right.
I noticed was the hat. It said Puerto Rico. I was like, aha, dope. Fire. Shout out to PR. We love you too.
But he did his thing, man.
He killed it, man. I loved it.
Yeah.
Nah, man, you. Okay, but let's explain. You used to be a choreographer, right?
Nah, man, I'm not talking about that.
You got an audience now?
I'm not talking about that. I can dance, yes. I get where he's trying to go with it. But I'm not I'm trying to, like.
Yo!
I mean, we're not gonna battle. This ain't no stomp. Like, I'm not gonna go to this young man and be like.
He don't wanna talk about it, man. Come on. Come on.
Like, what do you want? What do you? You
yo,
really gonna have
yo,
to?
You're showing your
go
age,
young
bro.
Man.
You're showing your age, man.
No,
look at
man.
You. Wow, look at you. Yo, congrats to Gil, man.
Congrats
wow.
to Gil.
Look at that growth, bro.
But I mean, if we was
man,
at a location and he came at me, that's
grown,
a whole
man.
Other situation.
Oh, what?
I'm just saying.
Oh, so if he was in front of you, crumping.
Like if he came at me,
if he was like grilling. If he came up to you crumping, what would you do, man? Tell me the truth, man. Gil will moonwalk out of there. He's so humble. He'll be like, yo, excuse me.
Smooth with it. Just slide out.
He's just straight moonwalking past everybody. Excuse me. Excuse me. Where's the bathroom? Second door.
I'm just going to slide
second
on
door
out.
Down the hall. He's moving.
And they're like, yo, he's killing it.
This dude's
I open the door, close
this
behind
dude's
me.
Grabbing hors d'oeuvres as he's walking by.
I'm grabbing hors d'oeuvres. Gotta need sustenance. I need sustenance.
The whole time, moonwalking. Boom, that's a skit. There's the skit. There's the skit. There's the skit. Fire. Fire. So go to D2Lproductions.com.
Please.
Check out the new merch. It's available there, man. There's the D2L on the bottom. That is going to be one of those shows.
Yo, and the shirt is being sold. Show it again, man.
I love you.
Show the people.
Yeah, here's the shirt again. My bad. Actually, I could show a picture of it. Oh, bang. There's the shirt.
Bang.
There's the gray one. Looks fire. I want to get the gray one too. Bang, the gray cap. We got black too. Different colors. This is the white one.
Yep. Fire.
Super dope. Go grab yourself the shirt.
Yep.
Let me see.
Landscape company.
Recap. Landscape. Yo, don't do that to me, man. Come on. Don't do that.
It's biblical.
Cause we're Spanish or something. What? Cause we're Spanish.
It's believable. Mario Escobar Live Landscaping.
Yo, Marty.
They're like, yo.
You are super foul for that, bro. Super foul. Your landscaping. Yo, listen. Go check out the song. Support the
It's
ministry.
A dope shirt. I'm saying. Support your if brother. You also would like it for other reasons.
Yo, you could use
you can
it,
use it for that.
While you're landscaping.
You're welcome.
It's symbolic, bro.
It is, man.
Like grass, man. As you're cutting it. Yeah. Sometimes
some of your friends would be like, yo, I don't understand. Like, what do you mean you feeling like grass?
Well, watch what I'm doing.
We're cutting all this. Like, you feel like getting cut? Like, I don't
understand. All right, bro. Are you trying to?
Like, nah, man, I'm trying to tell you.
You're butchering like my grass. Song right now. What are you doing?
I'm not butchering. I'm saying this is a great testimony for a
story. Sales pitch,
and the guy's like, oh, feeling like grass. We're cutting them, man. We're killing this thing.
We do have things we're going to talk about. Yo, hang
we
tight.
We talking about feeling like grass.
Hang tight.
All right,
hang
this
tight.
Is substance. Okay.
Thank you, brother. Man, we lost everybody. Everybody's just like, why do we listen to these cats, bro? Recap last episode.
It, yo, I love it.
It is what it is. Last episode. Let me see. Where's my notes? I need my glasses. Can you get my glasses?
Can you get my glasses?
Episode 103.
Don't
Mario
you wear
Esco.
Contacts?
Mario Esco live cookie. We talked about Kanye West, wash us in the blood. Wash us in the blood. And Travis Scott.
Did you have to say it like that?
Yeah, that's how it goes. We talked about Aha, Gazelle.
Walking
away from social media.
That stuck.
And we talked a little bit about the armed couple in St. Louis pointing their guns at the trespassers and the protesters coming
crazy.
In. Excuse me, y'all. Looking like a little Rambo.
Yo. He did.
So yeah, man. Like we played John Keith Bag featuring No Big Deal and Big Breeze Trap Praise featuring TJ Godfearing. Go check that out. Our last episode. We're gonna jump into a skit. This is Vocal Cut featuring Manny Rivera, Gil Vargas, and myself. And then we're gonna get into some real good discussions. But as the skit is playing, we're really gonna look for things to talk about. So here we go.
Pleasant, could it truly be? We'd rather die than to bless him. I pray I shatter every mind blind to this lesson. Either way, I'll let my talent shine while progressing. Yeah.
So what you guys think?
It's a little busy.
Yeah, man. It's busy. Busy. I think I gotta take some tracks out, man.
Yeah, I think you
know what you gotta do, man.
All right, hold on.
It's a blessing. Could it truly be? We'd rather die than to bless him.
Still too busy, bro.
Still?
Still too busy.
I think so, too. You know? Let's try one more thing. Hold on.
Sure.
I'm gonna try one more thing. Hold on.
It's a blessing. Could it truly be? We'd rather die.
That's it right there, right?
I pray I
should. Nah, bro. Nah, man.
Still?
Nah, still, bro. Still.
Yo,
still.
Serious.
Yo, still.
You know what? What? Yo, watch this right here. I got it.
You got something?
I got it. I got it. Just let me do my work.
All right, hold on, trust you, man.
Ready? Hold on, let me just take a quick listen. Yo.
You got
yo. All right, you know what? Yo, sit down.
Sit down.
Yo, sit down.
All right, I'm going to play in the speakers, man.
You
I'm
sure?
Not gonna, I want to blast this, man. I want to feel this.
Bro, I'm telling you right
sure
now.
You sure this is it?
Awards.
This is it.
That's all I'm saying. Awards.
All right, let's blast this. Yo, you got straight cut my vocals, man.
Yo.
Nah, but hold on.
Straight cut my vocals.
Hold on.
There you go. That was Vocal Cut with Manny and Gil Vargas and myself.
Yeah, that was
just a normal session, actually. That's normally how it goes. I go in, I work hard, I come out, they cut my vocals out, and they replace them. That's
how. Oh, how do you think your tracks come out so far?
Oh, so that's you ain't feeling like grass? That's you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's you.
I was sick.
You were like, yo.
I was mad sick, so you're my throat was real rough.
That's
so I was
like, feeling like grass. Yo, Vision on duty, brother, what's up, man? Shout out to that deity, though. I wish I had the logo ready. Dude, yo, your artwork is getting fire, by the way, brother. I like the bulb one you did. Did you see that one?
No, I haven't seen it.
It was a light bulb with salt dropping out of it.
Oh, yeah.
Building like a big sand.
Sick.
Yeah, dope. Love you, brother. I'm glad you're here with us. You missed out on all the madness before you chose.
Appreciate you taking the time.
You came in at the right time. Now it's like, oh, pastor's here.
No, pastor's here. Oh, pastor.
We used to feel that way with Shane. Remember that?
All the time.
Like, uh-oh, pastor's here. Everybody pastor behave. No, no, no.
It's Pastor Shane.
Oh, but it's Pastor Shane. So we got mad things to talk about today, man. I'm super excited about our agenda, bro.
Me too, man. Oh, I've never been more excited in my life.
Man, dude.
Like, the excitement kept me up.
Oh, my goodness, bro.
I couldn't even sleep.
First of all, you brought up a dope accidental topic that I want to talk about.
Oh, yeah. Like, how to move in this craziness.
How do you move in this? Yeah.
Yeah.
In this climate.
It's tough, man.
As, let's say.
You want to be responsible to your brand. You know, and being responsible to your brand is putting it out there. You know what I mean? You know, keeping it fresh in people's mind. But at the same time, you have to be respectful.
Talk proper.
Because you are promoting yourself in the midst of real issues right, in the world. So you kind of look crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, so that's, it's tough, man. For artists, it's tough. Because it's about you. And you know, that the last thing people want to see is anything about anybody else when there's a crisis.
Mm.
It needs to be about the topic. If not, shut your mouth. Mm. You ain't got nothing to say that's about this, be quiet. And it comes
is
off.
Is that really how it is?
It like, is, because it looks go, as rude. Think about it.
Now, you go
right
to different,
now, they're talking about justices spots and all these things, and then this dude is like, yo, buy my track. It's new. It just came out. It's on iTunes. It's going to be sick. Like,
that's you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm doing with feeling like grass.
People grieve it. Well, yeah, but that's different. You're not like promoting it in a sense like, yo, buy this, go get. It's actually.
I just said, buy my shirt.
The shirt. I'm not saying the song.
Yo,
go ahead, song, go ahead. You can stream it.
Feel the way you feel, brother, because that's the true fact. So what you're saying
it just
is,
feels weird. You know what I'm saying?
Do you
I
think
get it.
Personally it feels weird, like to you?
No.
You personally.
For me personally, no.
So you're just saying a perspective would be that it seems kind of weird.
Yeah. I think that is a perspective out
so
there.
So what are you supposed to do? Like, not make money? Like, what are you supposed to do in a time like this? Are you supposed
that's
to, like,
saying, like,
bunker
you,
down?
It's difficult because you have
stuff
to find a way to kind of promote your brand and at the same time be
I got a question
socially aware.
Hey, so, EC Holmes, this is a dope question. Hey, yo, what up, Go Yee? I see you. What up, Brandon? I see you. Guys, chime in, man. We want to chop it up. All right, I got a question for you.
Yeah.
During this time, is it wise, godly?
Mm-hmm.
Is it godly
mm-hmm.
for you to store up, collect as much as you can, gear up, be prepared for whatever might happen?
Yeah.
Or is that like a form of you're not trusting in the Lord, you're panicking, you shouldn't be storing up stuff for yourself
that? If you're doing it in a calm manner and you're just simply preparing.
Well, it's a
preparing
calm manner, so you're going to just do everything that you're...
No, I'm
you're
just
gonna
saying,
do
like,
it just calmly.
No.
You see what Gil said?
You said extreme, like,
if
panicking.
If you sin calmly.
No. Like, you said
you,
panic.
If you carefully.
You said panic. So if I'm panicking, that means I'm overreacting.
Oh,
right?
Dude. Yo, if you carefully.
Because I'm like, we got to pack. We got to get this ready. Like, now you're not in the right state of mind. You're not thinking rationally because you are panicking. You're at the point of you're going to break. Mm. So, no, I don't think that's right. Because you're not in the right state of mind. But if you're preparing and just simply preparing, like you never know what could happen. I think it's wise to always have at least a week or a month's worth of food. You never know. What if the grocery stores all get shut down for whatever reason and we can't get food? You never know. Weird things happen all the time. You should be prepared.
You're not lying about that.
I'm saying, yo,
still, I still
masses
can't,
of people getting sick over get like 3 month period. Like, you know what I'm saying? Completely demolished economy.
Calm
like
done.
It's
calm
crazy.
Done.
So
gonna grab this 96 rolls of toilet paper.
I don't think it's that bad to be prepared.
I'm gonna calmly grab this 96 rolls of toilet paper. I'm gonna calmly get hundreds of gallons of water at a time. Just very slowly
don't mind
in control.
Me here.
I'm gonna calmly loot over here. You guys, does this count?
You don't need this.
I'm gonna what if they calmly trespassed?
They calmly
in the gated community. What if they calmly?
You're making me sound crazy. Cause I never talked that. You're making me talk about like it has anything to do with emotion. It could be calm and still do something bad. What I was saying is that they were panicking. You know, so they shouldn't be panicking if they're making decisions.
Yo, Vision on Duty says yes, especially with the desire to be a blessing to others in need.
Yeah.
Remember, that's what Joseph did. Oh, shoot. When he preserved the land for the famine to come. Dude, wow. I'm in Genesis right now. I'm reading. I'm just like closing off on chapter 50 right now. I'm just closing off on that.
That's crazy.
That's wild. Yo, praise God for that. That's dope. Amen. Very good example, man. Joseph, was he wrong for that? For storing up?
I don't think so.
God is the one who gave him the wisdom.
Yeah, facts.
He had the wisdom. He knew what to do. He was the guy you wanted in charge for your stuff, man. You know what I mean? Like he knew how to manage his money. Everything he touched, he prospered. What are you gonna do, man? Like if you're in charge and you see this dude, he's prospering and everything. He's super, super wise with managing money and people. Of course you're gonna be like, yo, send this dude, you know,
number
get this
one.
Dude over here, man. Like, here, manage all my stuff.
Manage
you got
everything.
This, man. Tell me. And then he interprets his dreams. This dude gets the top of the line, you know, what do you call him?
But I don't know how I would feel.
Wizards. What do you call them? EC Home, you know.
That's such a weird power. Like, how do you tell
enchanters?
Somebody that you have this? Like, hey, man.
They're buying all that you let us. Yo, who's in there? They're buying all that you let us out here, man. I can't find my adobo. No, that's when you know there's a problem, bro. You're like,
this is ever a short of a
adobo.
No adobo? You're going to see a panic in the Spanish community that you ain't never seen.
I wonder sometimes if it was like Puerto Ricans instead of Israelites, would have been like empanadas?
But no, let me get back to this. Like, so this dude had the power.
Is that racist? I'm Puerto Rican, though. Does that count? I don't know.
I mean, if you're talking about
it.
Hey, it's okay if you talk about your own race.
I would prefer.
I guess that's an unwritten rule.
I would be happy with that. But go ahead.
So.
I want empanadas right
so
now.
So he had.
I might text Mom Dukes. Go ahead.
Text her.
Go ahead.
And then let me finish talking. So.
Empanadas on deck. Oh, man.
You just trying to make a title this whole time and I'm over here talking? You working out title ideas. This whole time I'm trying to have a real conversation. Sometimes. This dude is like, empanadas.
Yo, secretly.
Call Mom upstairs. Upstairs, Mom, empanadas.
It's one of those.
Empanada night. Yo.
You got to keep throwing it out till it catches. It's
the
like
the night of empanadas.
You're testing. This is my testing.
I'm like, this dude is just yelling random things. You got Mario Esco Live Tourette Syndrome.
Now that's the title. No, we can't call
that's
it that.
That's way too long.
No, go ahead.
Mario Esco Live Tourette Syndrome. Probably watch the show because
around.
It's going to be awesome. Title.
So go ahead, my bad. I'm sorry.
So yeah, it's a weird power, man.
Okay.
So he has the power to determine dreams. How do you even bring that about? Like, oh man, them leaves is crazy, man. Hey, if you ever have a weird dream, you can totally interpret it. I can tell you what it means.
Yeah.
Your intimate desires, intimate things that you dream about.
Yeah, I got
guy.
You.
That's weird. Like, how do you, that's such a weird power to have.
Mm.
And it's in the Bible, so obviously it's true.
Yeah.
But my point is like, that's such a weird thing. Like,
it's a weird skill.
Makes me think about did he tell Joseph that he interprets dreams? Like, they having like porridge.
You got to remember too, it was a different time. Like, they didn't have any scriptures. They couldn't open up the Bible to Genesis.
It's like, last night was a weird dream.
Can you imagine being in those times? You need that, bro. Like, you need the Holy Spirit to guide you because there's nothing to reference back on.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Like, how do you reference back on anything? Like, you don't have it in front of you.
Yeah.
But you're right, though. It is. Some people to this day still think they got those gifts, though.
Facts. And it's still weird. People,
it's still
don't
weird.
Go up to anybody and be like, I can interpret your dreams. And well, might as well fantasies.
When you're dreaming. So how do you move?
Still a weird dream.
Going back, how do you move? So you're saying like it just seems weird, right? Yeah. So it's not something that you rebuke. It's not like something like, yo, you still trying to sell music and stuff during this time? Like, I mean, business goes on. You gotta continue to work. Like, you gotta continue to provide.
People's lives on this. Like, so yes, it seems insensitive because they're promoting themselves, but that's how they make their living. Their personalities.
Okay, we're talking specifically celebrities.
Well, anybody who makes their money off their brand, like which is their face. Like,
yeah, online.
Yeah, marketers, like if they're social media like influencers or, you know, artists or, you know, anything where their face is
the brand. I got
the
you.
Brand. Like you
comedians,
have to.
Actors. This, yeah. That. Okay.
Like you can't just be like, oh, I'm not going to produce material because it's just not the right time.
Yo, that's their livelihood.
Do
you think it's super tough for like sports right now? Like as far as like how they're going to transition back?
That's another thing. It's a sensitive thing. But at the same time, there's been so much inclusiveness. Like people just being in their homes, cooped up.
Yeah.
You know, shows not
being
revamped.
So people kind of wanting. Like people are like,
yeah, they're like, we need something.
You got to get back to work.
Yeah, like, man. At this point, people want to go back to work. Legit. They're just tired of being home and just doing nothing and going to the grocery store, having to wait an hour with a mask.
Vision
on
Duty said the world will look back at this video and cancel Gil for saying that in 20 years from now.
Cancel me for saying what?
Oh, I want to hear it. He's laughing too. He's like, "Wepa!" Hello, I'm eating empanadas right now. Go eat. Go eat.
Oh, that's love messed you, up. Brother. That's messed up.
No, but I know what you mean. So they're utilizing what they, you know, their skill, their talent, their ability, whatever service that they're providing during a time like this. And, you know, that can be seen as respectful. Yeah. They got to, you know, so when do you say like, yo, enough is enough? Like, when do you say like, yo,
I mean, that's what I was saying is that some of these artists are being creative and they're like, you know, attaching themselves to an organization. You know, somebody that maybe is involved with inner cities or, you know, any, some kind of political agenda, some whatever, they're attaching themselves to that. So that way they can still create music and still be sensitive to what's going on in the world. They look informed, you know what I'm saying? Mm. So it kind of hits everything and it allows them to do it. And then afterwards, you can kind of continue doing your thing.
Because so you're saying it's what you're attached to. It's what you're doing.
That seems to be the strategy that's acceptable.
Okay.
Like so people don't have gripe with the guy who promoted this first and now continue promoting his albums.
Got it.
He's like, well, he's promoting his albums, but he's with us. So it's cool. Yeah.
It's attached to something else.
Yeah, he's not on his own, just, you know, selfishly
promoting himself. What about like, okay, so would that include like just anybody putting out albums, just like continuing with their process? Like,
yeah.
So then where's the problem? Like, where do you find the problem?
For me, I don't find a problem. But on other people, they say, wow, you are promoting yourself and your music and your, you know, product in this time where we should be focusing on this. So why don't you write, if you're going to write songs
Yo,
about
Vision
this.
Vision Duty, like, you know what's up. What I'm saying?
Like, they trying to control the narrative if you're not with it. And that's the issue.
Comment. True. That's
the issue.
That's why I was like, I'm not going to put
If you don't say anything, then they come at you.
Yeah.
So you have to kind of say something or have some kind of stance. You know, I have my stance. I believe Christ matters. That's my stance. I'm attached to Christ. Mm. That is where I'm citing. I'm not citing to any life that matters more than the other. And I know that's not what Black Lives Matter means and same vice versa to any organization. I'm just saying I believe Christ matters more than anything.
Oh, you went there.
So that's just my stance. Yeah. But it's okay to have a stance. If that's your stance, that's your stance.
I think it's like, you. For one, you can't read into the motives of people, right?
Yeah, you can't.
Like you can't assume. I can't look at somebody and assume. I got to admit, like sometimes I'm guilty of that. Sometimes I'd be like, oh, come on. You know what I mean? Like you cross by something, you're like, yo, in a time like this, like, come on. And then you're like, who are you, man? Like, you know what I'm saying? Yes. Like, who are you? Like, you can't, it's a case by case dependent on what they share in their moment. Like what they, like social media, like, yes, it can be gimmicky. People can use it for vain purposes. But it is another way to build relationships. I built a lot of relationships with a lot of these people right on this channel right now in the live.
Facts.
Through social media. You know what I mean? And it's been a dope back and forth experience the whole way through. Just kind of like learning, bouncing ideas off each other, just building with each other. You know, some people would say that it's not as political, you know what I mean? Like, as far as like...
Oh, we're not like political type.
Not politics. I mean like as political with entertainment. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Like, using
we're supposed to, like, right now, we got to switch up the convo, right? Like, now we got to talk about, okay, what's relevant this week in... You know what
I'm saying? That's what you're supposed to do. That's
now we gotta like the unwritten rule. Yo, like, it was dope just really opening up and having a dialogue just about something random that we're, you know, we're going through. And we can. That's the beauty of that.
That's sort of what we do anyway.
But you do feel the pull, right? Yo, EC Holmes, you do feel the pull, right? Like, sometimes you feel like, you know, the topic's got to be more, you got to be relevant. Like, you do feel the tug of being relevant. I did a post today.
But it's also a refreshing thing to bring out a conversation that maybe people don't think about and give a perspective maybe that somebody didn't quite, you know, go to that point. You know what I mean? That's why I like having free talk as well.
Yeah.
Because, you know, we're different people. Like, you may see something completely different from the way I see it.
That's very true, bro.
And I may see something completely different than
you.
Bro,
you know.
So it's good. It's healthy to talk about these things. And then people listening get to hear two different perspectives that may they agree with. They might disagree with both of us.
Yeah.
But like, nah, I don't see it like any of them.
There's a lot of those.
And that's fine. That's the dope thing about it.
They're like, what are these two dudes doing?
That's the dope thing about it.
Are they trying to blow? Like, what? Are they trying to make it
Well, I mean, that was the motive at one point.
No lie, man. I mean, that kind of comes with it, too. You do. We are in the flesh, too, right?
Like, yeah.
Even though we have new natures, new hearts that desire new things. That's the thing, though, that people don't get, is that the new heart and the new nature is separate from the old man. They're divided, bro. They're not uniformly one. They're not like, I am fully, you know what I'm saying?
Nothing.
It's not like Christ, you know what I mean? Like, the only thing we contribute is sin. That's all we contribute. Literally, like, all we contribute to our walk, literally, like, dudes, yo, but ladies and gentlemen, because I know there's some females. Yeah. I got yelled at on Twitter. The females were like, you didn't say, you know, the woman too. So I got to be cautious of the females too. What up, females? I love y'all too. Yo, shout out to the females out there. Shout out to the wifeys.
Shout out to my wifey.
Shout out to the wifeys listening.
Because you're my wifey.
Shout out to the ones soon to be wifeys. Shout out to the ones that are single young. Y'all better find some older sister to attach yourself to. Have some accountability. That's my little... should I drop the gem?
Yeah.
All right.
Gem.
Have some accountability to the older sisters in your church. Mm. You better listen to your mama. You better listen to your daddy. Yes. You know what I'm saying? All right. That's for the parents out there. That's for y'all. You can endorse us. Okay. So what were we talking about? So the pull, right? Like, you feel... I put a tweet. I don't know if we were going in this direction. I'll probably listen back and be like, totally off. But all right.
Totally off.
But we just go with it, right? So I did a tweet. It said, the culture conforms you to the culture.
Yeah.
Simple. It's like, it's logical. It like makes complete
sense. Sounds clear to me.
The thing is that it's so simple to understand, yet you see everybody being conformed to the culture. Like, it's like the most easiest thing to get, to grasp.
Mm-hmm.
And we all are so
tempted. We all fall into it.
To go right into to join right into the bandwagon, to jump right on the bandwagon, do the same things, try to, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like we talk about this a lot.
Yeah.
I feel like every week we talk about this. So maybe it's because of that.
Mr. Vision says, the good thing for us is the Bible is always relevant
I said this last week.
And since it's timeless, it will never get stuck in the moment.
Facts. You could read a verse, bro. Oh, is Dizzy got more?
Yeah, he got one more. And he says, speak on relevant issues and stay away from trendy topics.
Facts.
I love that.
Relevant. On relevant issues. Okay, that's
so
a different perspective.
So you can be thinking, a trendy topic, but you're taking the relevant issue.
Oh, shoot. Yo, EC. Oh, hey. Where's the...
Yo, we just put a gem out there.
Yo.
All
oh, no, that's
there.
The clap. Yo. Okay, yeah. Now that's real gems. You see? Yo, so go to check out that DD show. Maybe we're just the diving board show. Like, we're like like they walk and they're like, what is this? It leads you to a dope pool. Like,
it leads you to a dope pool.
Hey, man, I'm growing in my maturity, so I'm like, whatever you want me to be.
And when
Lord.
You jump in, you're gonna go, that's it.
Yo, Lord, whatever. You get to a point where you're just like, I'm beat. Like, whatever you want me to do, Lord. Like, you don't want nothing anymore. You're just like, whatever, just use me. All right.
Whatever.
You're gonna clean this tire over here, dope. Dope. All right, word. Like,
it is what it is.
Yo, just use me, man. I'm your vessel. That's when you grow in your maturity, you let go of your own desires, man. You start looking for God's.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm just going to do an awkward pause right there. And then we're going to jump into our music, our featured music. This is K Cartel, my brother. I love this dude's vibe. I love everything about this dude. I'm praying for you, brother, man. You know you got our support. We love you, bro. He was on the show, too. I don't have what episode it was, but you can check it out, man. Just put K Cartel, Mario Esco Live. It should come up. But shout out to K Cartel. We love you. His spotlight. Christian
comeback season. I just gotta let these people know what it is, man. Just be authentic and real with them. K-Cartel. Let them know about the Christ. Feel me? What he did for my life. That's facts. Look. Hey. Putting myself on the spot, giving all that I got so these people can witness your glory. I was enslaved to the weight, had too much on my plate, but it's out now, I'm telling my story. All in this world I was lost, but you showed me the cross. Now it's my turn to walk, that's a bet. Serving my Lord, keep the sword for the war. Slay like I'm Thor, and the Christ, I'm a threat. How about the church, I'm on 10, got a word from my pastor that spoke to my issues and problems. Self-discipline of itself, getting rid of this self is the first step to how I'ma solve them. Jump in that book, you in that book. Locked in, we loaded, we're ready, what's popping? Running them plays, had a chat with the coach on my hot 21 and I reading this option. We're going out in that church going up. About to blast off, I ain't talking about rockets. Haters, they lurk, depressed and they hurt. But I always show love cause that hate get too toxic. Speaking of toxic, I switch up the topic. Sharing good news that is sweeter than chocolate. The Lord to my case, look death in the face. The strong in the faith and put death in the socket. Putting myself on the spot, giving all that I got so these people can witness your glory. I was enslaved to the weight, had too much on my plate. But it's out now, I'm telling my story. All in this world, I was lost, but you showed me the cross. Now it's my turn to walk, that's a bet. Serving my Lord, keep the sword for the war. Slay like I'm Thor, and the Christ, I'm a threat. Running in circles, that brain getting dizzy. Couldn't keep a straight path for the thought I was tipsy. Demons be tricky, don't show you no pity. Actions be sticky, disguises be pretty. Crazy, too crazy, see God on the daily. Out for my safety, but safely and lately. Made a 180, them crosses be weighty. But it's all too gravy, cause I'm in the Navy. Down for whatever. Lord is the king, he's the king for forever. Out on a mission and down for whoever. Lord lead the way, cause we going wherever. Race lead to hell, it don't matter the weather. Word in me, man, I'm filled with gospel. Bar game only filled with truth. Gas pedal, gotta hit the throttle. Switch gears while I'm putting myself on the spot. Giving all that I got so these people can witness your glory. I was enslaved to the weight, had too much on my plate. But it's out now, I'm telling my story. All in this world, I was lost, but you showed me the cross. Now it's my turn to walk, that's a bet. Serving my Lord, keep the sword for the war. Slay like I'm Thor. In Christ, I'm a threat. How about the church? I'm on 10. Got a word from my pastor that spoke to my issues and problems. Self-discipline of itself, hey. Getting rid of this self is the first step to how I'ma solve them.
K Cartel, spotlight. Gil, can you please mute that? What up, brothers? What's going on? My dudes, what's going on? Hurry, check my Twitter, Cash Records. Check my Twitter, Mike 5, Vision Duty. What up, my brothers? Going back real quick to Vision Duty, and then we'll jump into our topics, right?
We should discuss this Baby Shark towel.
What?
What do you mean? Is that a Baby Shark towel?
Huh?
Is that a Baby Shark towel?
But it's not relevant. Yo, it's not relevant, all right? It's a trendy topic.
It's a trendy topic, and we're not going to discuss. We're not going to discuss
a trendy topic that we just learned a lesson
this
here.
It's pretty relevant.
Don't you remember the gem, bro? Oh, you got to hold on to the gems. You don't just drop them. Mm-hmm. You don't just take them and throw them around. You got to talk about relevant issues. So, I like that. So, you take away from trendy topics, relevant issues. Is that?
Yeah. Cool. So, you talk about trendy topics, but the relevant issue about
cool.
that
Thank
topic.
You, Vision That's Duty. That's a dope one. On duty, vision
That's
on duty.
That's a dope
duty. One. Shout out to that deity, though. We love y'all. Go check them out. The Definitely. Bar Podcast, the Bar Network. Go check it out. You joining Definitely. In, share the show. What up? Okay, first topic. Yeah. Go ahead, Gil. Drop it.
Go ahead. Drop it like it's...
What's our first thing that we're going to discuss today? What's relevant in our culture today?
That's a big fat...
What is relevant in our culture now? If we're like CHH, technically, is that what we are? Is that... We hashtag CHH, right? That's our demographic.
I suppose.
I think it's the closest that comes with it. What am I supposed to hashtag? Like CCM? Like, what am I?
CCM!
Every time I hashtag Christian theology, I always get the mad angry guy that's like, I thought this was Christian. So I'm like, okay, obviously it's not theological sound.
you're definitely not going to get that.
What am I supposed to hashtag, man? CHH, man. Christian hip hop, I guess. Good times. I don't know. y'all help me out.
Laugh a lot. LOL.
What am I supposed to talk about? Lecrae saying he regrets being a CHH artist?
Oh.
Am I supposed to talk about that? What am I supposed to talk about?
We need like a CHH sound. Like
is that
CNN,
like the topic
when
to
it's
discuss?
Like breaking news and it goes
CHH says.
So we need CHH one.
Lecrae says. What did Lecrae say? It's like Lecrae could walk outside.
We need like a sound effect like CHH. That's it. Something like that.
Whoa. Something you mean like that will be the
yeah, we have to hit that. Whenever it's breaking,
whenever
CHH
we're gonna talk
news.
About CHH, it's gonna be like, dude, we could record this, bro.
Yeah, we
like,
gotta do that.
So then why don't we do that?
CHH, that's it. Because it's always usually
this
like
isn't
quick.
A Christian podcast. It's a podcast that's Christian.
Perfect.
Yo, facts.
That should
this
be our
isn't
tagline.
A Christian podcast.
Man,
it's
that could have been our tagline.
You know,
we taking that. That's
okay,
gonna
okay.
Be a,
see, Go Yee wants to know.
You
all right.
Take that.
Rapzilla put out a tweet. Okay. What's your favorite era of CHH? Let's report it. Reporting to you live.
What's your favorite era? Why do you give him that voice?
I'm sorry, dude. It's
what's
just,
your favorite era?
I'm sorry. I got to show more respect, right?
Why is you use that voice?
Let me log into to Twitter real quick on the fly.
On the fly.
Live and uncut on the fly.
So go ahead, go to Twitter.
We're gonna look it up right now. What did they tweet?
What did Lecrae say?
The funny thing is that when they tweeted it, I saw the tweet. Then I saw the response. Then I saw the follow up retweet with a snapshot of the response.
Oh wow!
Hold up, where is it?
That's diligence.
Yo, they deleted it. I don't see it.
Oh, if they did, that's
they probably
a
deleted
little
it. I don't see it. Or maybe it's somewhere.
Why
anyway,
the comments?
So they said something about the era. What's your favorite era in CHH? And they put up these dates. I don't know what it was, all the way up until now. And then Lecrae chimed in and said something around the lines. Go check it out. It's somewhere on there. I don't know if they deleted it. Oh no, here it is, right here. What's your favorite CHH era? And they got 1985 to 95, 1996 to 2006, 2007 to 2020.
So basically all of it.
I didn't come around to know about CHH until how long ago, Gil? About maybe.
Yeah, but what you knew about it doesn't mean that it didn't exist before that.
No, I know, but I'm trying to figure out.
But it still hasn't existed that long.
No, I know, but I'm trying. No, it did. It existed when hip hop started. There was Christian rappers.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, there was Christian rappers.
That's crazy.
They even had dudes like doing like spoken word, like jazz, like a form of hip hop. Like they were just, you know.
Yeah, I remember. I think it was Brent that put me on to one of them dudes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Brent
is our like, resident hip hop.
They had Christian artists, rappers, like doing their thing, like for just as long as hip hop.
That's pretty dope.
Hmm.
Hmm.
So, I don't know. What I'm saying is
one would claim they have just as much validity as hip hop.
Oh my goodness.
One would claim.
I don't know, man. Like people have different perspectives on it. I always, when I first came into it, I always felt like it was always lagging. I always felt like it was always.
But a big part of that is because think about it like this: the reason why mainstream is so popping is because they have the resources to make it popping. You know what I mean? And
Goyi says he didn't know until like 3 years ago.
It's a broader audience. You know what I'm saying? The most, you know, they're talking about partying, having fun, love, sex, drugs. You know what I'm saying? It's a broader appeal compared to talking about Christ. So you're not going to get a lot of sales, which means you can't get better engineers or better producers, better. So it's not, it's going to take
not
longer
just that,
for it
not
to
just,
evolve.
Not just that, not just that, but also managing money, having teams, like
yeah.
having.
And
having
all those things
whole...
come with those professional people that you can't afford.
Right.
You know what I mean? When you can afford it, then yeah, you get the works and you get the people who manage your funds, people who manage
so do you
your
think,
tours,
do you,
people.
So
who,
would you say it's good to pardon where they were at in that time because they didn't have the funds to do it. So they were being faithful in that time with what they had. Is that what you're saying?
I mean, they had no choice. If they wanted to make money, you know what I'm saying? They had to do what they had to do. But what I'm saying is that you're saying, like, for the most part, Christian hip hop has always been lagging. That's because they don't have the funds
in comparison to the music in the time, in my opinion.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I mean?
And in that time, you know, those people had money to create
projects. Not now. Like, my opinion has changed.
But the thing is,
drastically now,
the skill level has also changed. Like,
the artists are learning the gear. They're learning the plugins. They're recording themselves. They're making bangers straight out of their living
room. That's what I'm saying. It's evolved.
Legit. Like, they're making hits.
But it wasn't as fast as secular because secular had the resources much quicker. Where you're talking about a religious thing, you know what I mean? It's not going to be as many people running by the hundreds and millions and, you know, coming to buy your product because it's a niche where you get the secular music opens to a lot more people. It's not really a niche. You know, you can't say hip hop is a niche. It's like it's a genre. It's a brand. Like,
yeah.
It's huge. Mm-hmm. So you're tapping into that, but because of the topic that you're talking about, you're creating a whole new subgenre that nobody's aware of, that nobody knows, that nobody's really looking for.
There's not really a lot of avenues for it to come up.
Yeah, so it's going to take a long time for it to build where hip-hop was already built and it's growing and growing.
Which, by the way, yo, salute to everybody who's putting it work because it's building its own, like...
People who didn't give up.
It's actually building its own umbrella right now, like... Yep. From all different angles.
Mainstream is starting to recognize and bring them to the platforms.
Right, you know right.
You're seeing,
ushering in the people who are putting in work. People who are putting in work are being recognized and they're being saluted. Like, I've seen, shout out to the crew. We love y'all.
For real.
I seen them, you know, when they first started with their videos. I always saw the crew like the DJ Academics of CHH.
Legit.
You know, so I always used to, like, you know, message him on Facebook, whatever, like, yo, you like the DJ Academics, you know, just give him props that I see what you're doing, you know, influencing in his way and doing his thing. And now, like, yo, he's at a point where Rapzilla is clearly, like, you know, tagging him and stuff, recognizing him at least. He's a how do you call it? Our radio host friend? Or what do you call it? How do you call it? Our,
I'm not sure what
he's part of GH3 Radio, so he's part of the family.
He's a coworker.
Yeah, there you go. He's a coworker from a colleague. All right, there you go.
That's the word.
Shout out to GH3 Radio and others that are putting in work. So, like, since we started the show, and I know the people who've been following us the whole time know that I've said this before, but to the new people jumping in, since we started the show, we were kind of, you know, pointing out the areas that we needed to see improve.
Yeah.
And since then, like, it's grown to become its own thing. And it's like, wow, look at this thing. Look where it's gone. I mean, there's a little danger to it because if you have too much
growth too fast,
maybe that too. Yeah. Well, yeah. In that, there's mistakes made, right? And you have to learn. Yeah. But if you have everybody just clicking up on top, and if somebody feels a certain way, like, you kind of feel the pressure to go with that certain direction. You know, you start building a culture, and then if it sways toward somewhere where it could be dishonoring God, you kind of feel compelled to go with the culture, with the group. I feel compelled to go with the influence of the group. And in that situation, you got to take a stand. How far of a, like, what are you doing with the influence? What are you doing with the following? Yeah. What is the plan with that? Because you can use that to your advantage, right? You could be like, yo, I'm going to expose this brother over here. And there goes his reputation. If you're too much like a TMZ or you're too much like a gossipy, you know what I'm saying? Like, and you're like, yo, I can utilize my influence to straight tarnish this dude's reputation and bury this dude. So
which
now,
has happened.
Which has happened, you know?
You
and
know,
that 50
is... 50 Cent, Ja Rule, he just straight demolished his career.
What was that about? Okay, go ahead. Thank you. Switch up the topic. Let's go.
That's exactly that. He used his influence to completely demolish
Tell the
Ja
people
Rule.
What happened.
50 Cent got into a beef with Ja Rule. You know, I don't know the specifics on why they beefed, but...
No, it wasn't. You're talking about that. I thought you were talking about the recent incident with T.I.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh, okay.
Go ahead. Then you speak on it. What happened to T.I.?
T.I.
What had happened?
T.I. started, I don't know, it was a phone call with Kevin Hart for some reason.
Mm-hmm.
And T.I. just started going off on 50 Cent. and saying that he's the king of ATL and da-da-da-da, and he just, like, started going at 50 Cent. And then 50 Cent responded.
Did 50 Cent say something to him first?
I don't know what it was. I don't know what... Look it up, man. I don't... This is what happens when you don't got the topics ready. And then and then 50 Cent responded back.
50 Cent beef.
50 Cent responded. Yeah, it's the first thing that probably comes up. And 50 Cent responded back and, like, showed a video of T.I. doing an infomercial for, like, a hotline to, like, basically, like, rat on people.
Really?
Like, you got any tips or something like that? Like, and it's T.I. doing an infomercial. Oh, my goodness, dude.
So this is T.I. Is it on the rumor report?
Yeah, it's somewhere, man.
I just want to hear
it. And it's like, yo, it's so weird to watch how these people move, bro. Like, how do these celebrities just find these videos and just totally disrespect each other on their platforms with millions of followers and they're cool. And they're like, ha ha, you got me.
T.I. challenges him to a battle?
I guess that's what it was. Oh, yeah, the battles they're doing, the online battles, the music, they go back and forth, that thing. T.I. saying, like, his catalog can match up with 50 Cent or something like that.
I don't know.
Can he? No, 50 Cent. Actually, that's a good topic.
I think 50 Cent got more hits.
You think so?
Yeah. Well, we could compare.
You'll be surprised, bro. T.I. is just as impactful.
He has some hits, but not consistently like 50.
It's like a pure New York
50
versus...
had like a streak where he was just pumping out hits after hit after hit. Not songs I would agree with, but he was hitting them hits like just back to back. 60 and 50 everywhere. He had two albums back to back that were just like solid. I don't know.
He said, go to war with 50, you lose every time.
Yo, it's crazy.
Versus
man.
Battles. There goes Jay. There's Jay. See, there's the inside guy right there. There's another podcaster. I swear, this podcast is for podcasters. I think we just for y'all, yo.
Hey, man.
Hey, what's up, podcasters?
That's pretty dope, though.
We got mad podcasters in the building. We got Mike 5. We got the Deity Show. Yep. We got, what's the name? That ain't Christian. What's going on? Bro, you've changed the topic 500 times.
We even got Cash Cow Records.
No doubt. That's how we do. What topic are we on anyway? 50 Cent T.I. Yeah, okay.
50 Cent T.I.
So we bounced from Lecrae. And his tweet. What happened with that? What was our conclusion with Lecrae? And he regretted
saying that he was CHH.
That he wasn't CHH.
Which is funny to me, in my opinion. It's funny. Because I know.
And we'll go back
it.
To the T.I. You see how we do it? You see the logic?
I knew it. That's how we roll. If you don't
you
like
see the
it,
logic?
If you don't like it.
How can you see how we do?
Like it.
This is on point.
No, but listen. So real quick, before I forget. See? Now I forget. See what happens? I lost it.
Now, Lecrae.
Oh, Lecrae.
Oh, Lecrae talked to T.I. too.
Oh my gosh. You just completely blew my mind just now. Now I'm just like, all stories have just mumbled together. T.I. Sometimes Lecrae. Oh, they just spoke to me. Oh my gosh. Do their wives know each other? I don't know. Did Lecrae, they have dinner? They had lunch.
Lecrae had a conversation with T.I. too. Wow.
Jeez.
That was a while back though. I think that's old news. Jay, can I still talk about that or nah? Was it?
Oh, okay, yeah, so, I remember my point now.
All right,
so
first Lecrae.
I always knew right when Lecrae said, oh, I'm a Christian, I'm more of just a hip hop artist that, you know what I'm saying, that happens to be Christian, so that's how I am. I'm not into this box. I knew it back then. It was just about PR, how to be perceived, so that way his market could be a little bit more broader and he's not being put into a box. I knew it from back then. And now he's noticing that the box ain't really that big.
Oh.
Because why would you turn down a record deal to come back to your record label, which you were fine doing, and now he's saying, I regret, man.
Jay says the content, the content never changed, though. He fell back from theology rap, but he was still spitting Jesus.
Yeah. But it's you can clearly hear the difference. And every person who's a huge fan of Lecrae, and even still is a huge fan of Lecrae, says that there was a difference between his albums when he was really spitting Christ compared to...
These dudes are bugging, by the way. But go ahead.
Doing some songs and mentioning Christ. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, yes, he's mentioning Christ. He reps him, which is dope.
Yeah.
But he's straight away from repping Christ, like really talking about Christ. Ooh. Because he wanted to narrow his network. You see it. You know, that's why he started doing tracks with secular artists. You know what I'm saying? He even said it in interviews. You know, I don't want people to perceive me as that because sometimes it can be a negative thing. Like they don't even want to listen to you just because you are.
Yo, I gotta read this. Hold up. On Vision Duty, Vision on Duty says he was spitting Jesus, but then spitting on the bride of Jesus.
Woo!
I think what that stems from, and that's a dope convo, and then we'll go off of that to T.I. and 50, and then we'll bridge off of that to T.I. back to Lecrae, and then we'll bridge off of that.
Thanks. Checkmate.
Cool.
I don't know. I felt like saying that. Just because
I think was a dope convo to spin off of that is the anger that we have toward the church, bro. Like, yo, sometimes, like,
that whole "it's not cool" thing. That's really, you know what I mean?
I can't speak like that against Lecrae. I don't know what.
No, I don't know.
I can't speak on his.
I'm just saying,
his
like,
situation.
Well, he said himself that it was about how.
But
he
you
was
do
being
see,
perceived.
You do see a lot of people around that time where Lecrae bounced out. Remember that time? It was like this weird moment where there was like people like.
Yeah,
even the faith,
tight.
And everyone was like, "Yo!" Everyone was going crazy. Like, who?
People
another one drops.
Like,
another
like,
one
like
drops.
Lecrae
like
left
one.
The faith.
Yeah.
All he was saying is that he was.
I'm not
going to
be doing that
genre.
Music like that.
Yeah. People lost their minds. Like,
they were like, "Yo!"
To me, I didn't see it no different because he's a musician. This is his livelihood. This is how he lives. This is how he feeds his.
So
family.
You were cool with it.
So if he decides to change his product, that's his product. I mean, it was weird that he saw it as a ministry, and it was all ministry. Then the money comes, and then now I want to flip this product.
So let me ask
that
you
part
something.
Is a little.
Let
off,
me ask
that,
you something.
You know,
if you were in his shoes, and then you started making money with your ministry, and you
I
saw an
made,
opportunity to make money off product
before I would have made the decision to change the product and say, "Look, I'm going to change it and do this route," I would have at least let the fans know that. They're changing their stance on.
They did. They said. They did. They said our mission statement.
Yeah, they just removed a couple statements.
We're gonna remove the scripture.
What I'm saying is,
all right, y'all. We're gonna remove the scripture from our mission statement.
Yeah. What I'm saying is that it was never an announcement.
Jay right now is
it wasn't
like throwing
until,
popcorn at the screen.
It wasn't until people
y'all
went in on him. It wasn't until people went in on him in articles and, you know, interviewing him and saying, "Oh, what do you mean by this?" and grilling him, that he explained further. But there was no statement like, "Look, guys, I really want to just be an artist and not be confined to a specific topic. Like, I want to talk about anything, life experiences, love, marriage." You know what I'm saying? I'm never going to abandon my faith, which he never did, because he always mentioned God in his music, showing I am a man of God. I'm a man of faith, but I'm talking about other things. I'm talking about life and this and that and whatever.
I think he has.
He just
been,
wanted to be open to talk about whatever. And
I think he has been open about a lot of his struggles, though. He has been
throughout.
He has
yes.
confessed over,
throughout. Yeah.
I mean, this is one of them we're talking about.
But
it.
I'm saying that you know, like, that was the biggest argument that people had is like, "Yo, this just came out of nowhere. That now you're just kind of like separating yourself from the Christians, and now you're just a hip hop artist." You know,
so what do you think is happening to him right now?
Now, I believe that he's starting to get older and realizing these titles are stupid and we shouldn't even be paying attention to that and just be who we are. If he's a man of God, he's a man of God. And if that's what he wants to do and make that proclamation and like, "Oh man, I wish I never did it." Hey, then I guess this is his way of repenting and kind of coming back to his roots and realizing that it was foolishness.
Mm.
That's my take. Because he went and did it. He went to the label. He was living that life of the artist. And, you know, even though he had a successful label on his own, he went and did that business move to elevate his music career. And apparently it just didn't pan out, because if it was popping, why would you leave it?
Or maybe he just saw what was behind the curtain and he was like,
or that.
You know,
yeah,
what?
True.
I don't want this life.
That's true.
I'm going back to ministry. I'm going back to the basics. Because real talk, like, you know, obviously he's in a whole different space. He sees more things than we can see, you know what I'm saying? And his where he's at. Yeah, obviously he's full time, he's doing his thing. He understands how this works. He has a lot of experience with this. You know? We could see behind the curtain
and actually,
too, but just
I actually remember
not on that level where he's
now
at.
We're talking about it. he actually did make a statement regarding the whole move, and it was something along the lines of that he wanted more control, and there were certain things that he wanted to do creatively.
I'm gonna get
and,
on that, Jay.
You know, because he signed to a label, he has to run those ideas through the label execs. They have to approve it.
Yeah.
Sometimes they don't agree with the direction. So now there's that political back and forth. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. You got somebody else's hands on your stuff.
Exactly.
Man. I know what that's so, the
yes,
worst, bro.
He had the power of a more because
somebody could straight hold you up. Like, someone could straight hold up your direction. Like, you want to go off, you want to send this out, and somebody could just straight pump the brakes on the
Which
entire
is why,
process.
If you're paying attention to how the artists are moving, more and more
are going independent.
Artist why tip. Is that? Because you got these execs saying, nope, I don't want
creative
you talking
tip.
About that.
You know.
Nope.
Yeah. Go ahead. What's the creative tip?
Independence is grace.
Yo, this is the moment where our quote
independence
unquote,
is
our quote
bliss.
Unquote competitors are like, see, they don't know what they're talking about. This is that moment where they're like, yeah, look,
we got him.
See,
guess what?
They don't know.
We
what they're
say
talking
it all
about.
The time that we don't know what we're talking about. Boom.
Nah, we know some things, all right? we share a little bit that we know. And you know what? Some of them are starting to catch on to that and be like, yo, I'm gonna start giving more gems out. A lot of the artists I'm seeing are taking ownership. Like, remember how we used to talk about that? Like, what's up with people not taking ownership? Like, now I'm seeing a lot of people take ownership of that.
That's
what's up. So, creative tip, go ahead.
So, yeah. What did I say?
Oh, come
independence.
On. Come on.
Wait. Independence is bliss.
There you go. Hold up.
I had a microphone, I would have dropped it, but all I got is a mouse. So
independence
drop
is
the mouse.
Bliss. Okay? No.
And it got connected with my computer. Bam.
All right, real talk. So the beauty of independence is that you skip out on the deadlines. You could take your time to perfect your craft. You don't have somebody breathing over your shoulder 24/7 trying to, you know, steer your direction. You can you have the freedom to be as creative as you want. You can go in the direction that you want. You're your own boss. That's the beauty of being independent. The problems with being independent is if you don't have the money, the finances, or a budget to back yourself up, to invest in music videos, to invest in art covers, to invest in mixing, mastering, recording, the gear that you need. That's the downfall of it. So I would say, like, if you can find a way to make a full-time income, like a full-time living, and then make music your side hustle that gives you some cash in, it's better that way, because if you build up your finances, you're smart with how you invest and stuff like that. Look at Gil's looking at me like, didn't we have this talk not too long ago?
That's fine. It's a good refresher.
You can get on me.
It's a good refresher.
Fine. You can get on me. That's okay. So if you do that, you have the freedoms in the musical realm. But if you make music your main bread and butter, and you don't have that financial backing, or you don't have your creative control over the art that you create, well then, sorry, bro. This is... I hate to put it like this, but
I mean, think
it's like
about
a slave master relationship.
Out
you
there,
you know
like,
what I mean? You got to do what the boss
reason,
tells you to do.
The main reason why we wanted record deals is for distribution. You are now able to distribute your music globally instantly. So all you need to do is just work hard and get it in front of people. You got to work hard. That's just now it's on you. Mm. That's all it is. But you got the same power that these record labels have. The only difference is that they have the resources to do it faster, but you can still do it. You just got to grind it out.
Right. Yo, and a lot
they
of
just
that,
can do it fast.
Yo, real
overnight,
talk,
they can make
real,
you famous.
Real talk, and I'm going to say this for the Christian creatives, right? Because that's what we are, right? So for the Christian creators that do listen, probably when I'm long and gone, like, as you guys go back and reflect on the show that didn't pop, but now you're like, oh man, where'd these guys go?
Facts.
They're long
or
and gone.
Or you might find these in the dirt somewhere and be like, these lost
tapes. So when you go back,
let's go live.
Yo, enjoy the creative process, bro, because everything is made, if you're a Christian, right, and you're creative, everything is made to conform you into the image of his son. So the entire creative process is actually God teaching you some things.
Yo, amen.
Real talk. Yeah. You know how much I've learned in this journey? Matter of fact, I just text the director of Spiritually Dead today. And I remember the conversation that he had, because that's what launched me on my drive, which a lot of listeners already know. That's what launched me on my journey in this musical path to take it as a career and like, oh, shoot, I want to get in movies. I want to get into this. I want to get into that.
Well, it was crazy.
What I bypassed, and this is something that's new out of this. I'm not going to share another story that I shared 60 times. Mm-hmm. Is that he said the reason why I called you to do that video in the first place is because God told me to. Now the red flags go up, right? Yo, the EC Holmes is like, hold on a second, y'all just went left.
Pump your brakes.
Y'all just went left. What happened? All right, yo, this is the story. He's a homicide detective,
yep.
Right? Really stressful, you know, situation going on, really stressful day. And he was just tired of the everyday just stress, you know what I'm saying? So he wrestled with that. He's like, I need something. I want to have gratitude. I want to, you know, I need something to, you know, so he prayed about that. He wrestled about that. And immediately he thought of me. I came to mind. And he felt compelled to reach out to me and do this video for me out of the need to feel some sort of gratitude. And like, I want to give back, man. I'm always stressed out. I'm always like, and he shared that with me. And I'm like, it just reminded me like, whoa, God literally in his providence was the one. Cause I got a random phone call. I wasn't looking for no videographer. I didn't care about videos. You know, I was doing Theology 24. Does anybody remember Theology 24? Probably not. My
Don't look it up.
Yeah, I was doing.
It's none of your business.
It's not. This is long before Wrath and Grace. This is like, yeah. Yo, if anybody does know that, that's crazy. You really rocked with me for a minute.
Wait, Jay's saying, hustle makes for good bars, but artists are afraid of grind. The Bible talks about harvest, but anyone who has ever done any farming, gardening knows that that's when the work begins. Yo, or lose your yield.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing, bro. Facts. Here's the thing about that. Yo, work. Actually, and what entails with that, when you talk about the artist afraid of the grind, what entails with the grind, right, is not just you slaving over chasing the bag. You know what I'm saying? How they say it? Yeah. We got to go get the bag. It's not about that. The part of the grind is you looking to be conformed into the image of his son. You got to remember, I'm going to keep bringing it back, bro. That's like going to be my thing right now. Like, I don't know. That's going to be my drive. Like, I'm going to keep bringing it back to the spiritual side, man. Because I see a lot of people talking about the, you know, I see a lot of theologians talking about the in-depth things of the Bible, right? Like, oh man, this and history and Greek and breaking it all down. Then I see a lot of people who are like, yo, go with the grind. Go get it. Go da-da-da-da, the Gary V's of CHH. Mm. I don't see nobody in between like, yo, man, we're spirit and we grind. Like, yo, I know, I feel you. I'm a layman. I'm a worker. I'm a 9-to-5 guy. I know a grind. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to pay bills. I know what it's like to be like, man, how am I going to pay this one? Like, yeah, I got family to feed, bro. I got things to provide. And I struggle because God has blessed me with a talent and ability to share certain convictions and things through music. It's been a part of my life since I was young. That's just, it is what it is. And here I am sharing, spilling myself online in front of everybody to see what it's like to be a person who wrestles in this journey that wants to create and desires to want to honor God through music and lyrics. And, and then I want to be pure. I want to glorify him, but I got a family and a wife. And I come so close. I come so close, man. EC Holmes, I come so close. I'm like, I'm with GH3. I'm like, oh man, I'm right here, y'all. Like, push me a little further, man. Like, I'm spitting on Gil. I'm so excited over here, man. He's getting Holy Spirit spit.
I'm glad I'm wearing glasses.
I'm spitting on the Bride of Christ right now. My bad.
Spitting on the Bride of Christ.
My bad.
Well, technically, I am.
Wipe yourself down, bro. Oh, man. I'm spitting on the Bride of Christ right now.
Now
bro.
I know why you got the baby shark towel. Yeah, because now I'm swimming.
But maybe that's part of the thing that we're doing as well. You know what I'm saying? Like trying to address the things and bring them all together to find that, not common ground, but find that understanding of the creative journey. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We try to talk, like now I'm way off topic. See what happens when we don't got stuff in front of us?
That's fine. That's our normal daily life.
I'm done. Sorry. I'll do that. If you don't stop me, I'll keep doing that. You have to stop me, bro.
That's us.
All right, so Lecrae, CHH, he did that. T.I., 50 Cent, yo. They're beefing again, blah, blah, blah. What else? What else do we got to talk about?
Dang.
Yo, what else do we got to talk about, man? Kanye West going for president. Are we gonna even entertain that?
Hey, man, he seems serious, man. He got a running mate and everything. Some girl.
All right, yo, it's 9:16. We go to 9:30, right? We got how much time? All right, let's jump into it.
Let's do it.
I'm feeling the need.
What do you want to talk
Will
about?
Will Smith.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Will Smith and Jada Pinkett, the whole...
What's the news? What happened?
Well, some, you know, it seems like there's a someone coming out stating that he had a relationship with Jada and that Will Smith gave the blessing. Like, this is the part that's kind of weird. They changed their view on marriage. So they didn't see themselves as married. They got rid of that term. And they were now life partners, like just partners in a spiritual sense, which I don't understand.
Okay.
But
hold up.
So that's how they describe their relationship.
Did they say that? Did they say we are changing the definition of our marriage?
No, they just decided together to get rid of the idea of the word marriage.
So did they like document? Was this like a document?
This was on the Red Table Talk.
No, okay. So then this is just something that they're deciding within themselves.
Yeah. No, it's not like they went and got their marriage license and said, we would like to change.
I thought they were like trying to contract. Make a political move. Like, we are going to do partnerships now.
But
like,
these are the things that people are talking about because of the situations that they're now being brought up again as swingers or, you know, their open marriage or whatever you want to call it. Like, they're allowed to be with whoever.
Other people. Yeah.
So this guy's coming out saying, yeah, Will Smith knew about it. You know, blah, blah, blah. There's a whole interview on it. So now people are talking about it again, saying, is it true? She has denied it. She's going to, I guess, do a Red Table Talk and get more in depth about the situation. But this is a reoccurring thing. So now people are really starting to be like, yo, maybe this is true.
So now people are trying to adopt this ideology.
Yeah, it's like, you know,
they're trying to adopt this way of thinking.
And that seems to be...
You know what? I could see that creeping into. I hope to God not. But I could see people trying to utilize like...
Yo, shout out to Ruslan. He has a really good take on this, man.
Go ahead. Shout out to Ruslan. So what was Ruslan's take? But I could see people trying to utilize this to say, Christians, to say, oh, what about, I don't know, King Solomon. Look at how many wives he had. Look at David.
Yeah, and
look
at how many wives he had. Like, that's actually an argument, you know. Ruslan mentioned it in his video.
Jada, popcorn.
It's a great point. Is that...
Yo.
That,
wait, I love you, Jay.
What was it you said again?
Yo, don't lose it.
I lost my point.
I'm sorry.
Remind me, refresh my mind.
I don't even know.
We both forgot. Dope. Yeah, because that's how we roll. In case you don't know,
Jay just totally came in and interrupted me.
You always do that. Like, don't be reading the comments when we're in a dope conversation.
All right, so she has an open relationship. She's trying to change the narrative of marriage. And people say, "What about David and this one?" And they have tons.
That's a bad analogy because of the fact that every time there was multiple marriages or multiple relationships, it never worked. There was always bad things.
Oh, facts.
It never
worked. Give me an example.
Solomon, you know what I mean? He couldn't.
Oh, when he started adopting the false idols. I mean, they're false
gods. Yeah, look at what happened. Like, little by little, things started to change because you can't keep track. How do you keep that many wives happy? And to each one have their own desires. They were like, well, I worship this God. And he's like, well, the smart thing to do is just agree and nod your head. Just like most husbands.
Oh, careful. Careful, wifey watching. Just do it. You can't let too much go, brother. Like,
all your husbands know.
Yeah, it's
look good. Look at this curtain.
It's good you got an hour drive home, bro. You got a lot of time to pray. You're going to be like, yo, Father.
I'm just saying.
All right. Go ahead. You can't keep track of it. So you're saying it's bad because one is enough.
No, I'm saying one is the intended number, and I understand the logic behind it.
This brother said
one is the only number.
This brother just basically said
any other thing is impossible.
It's one because one is enough, bro. Like,
yes, it's perfectly enough.
How about a man leaves his mother and father to hold on to his wife? You know what I mean? Like, how about what the Bible says? No, this dude,
I'm not saying that is the that is the a council.
The reason like, why so the you shouldn't have is, more than one. It's because no, one I is never enough. Said that.
I never said
you
that.
You definitely got to pray. You got an hour of prayer right before you get home, brother.
I'm sure the wives feel the same way.
Yo. Oh, man. Okay.
I'm sure the ladies are probably like, oh, my God, if I had five of him.
There's speaking of wifey. Hi, wifey. I love you.
Oh, wifey. How would you feel if you had five Marios?
How would you feel if you if I
had... To love and hold and cherish.
Actually, you're a wife.
Sickness and health.
You're a wife. Yeah, of you're one that husband. Species. You can help us out as a, give us a female perspective. What are your thoughts about Will Smith
and Jada?
Yeah,
open relationship.
Here, can I plug a mic in for you? No. All right, so I'll repeat you. Go ahead.
Not that what you're are on
you
camera.
You won't see. They won't see you.
I feel that this is a.
Yeah. Okay.
But how do you feel about it?
Why good answer. She said they're in an open relationship. Obviously, that's wrong.
Cool.
Good Christian answer. Thank you, my
You should
wife.
Write a book.
I love you. Yeah, there you go.
Like, well, I don't believe in this because it's bad.
Boom. Because the Bible told me. Yeah, that, yo, real talk, you skip a lot of pain if you just do what the Bible tells you to do. Like, yo, you will skip tons of pain and
like,
stress.
Yo, man, every time, man, I see all the stuff that my friends have, and dude. I want it. I want it so bad. I just want to take it, and I just want to steal it. Man, yeah. I just want this stuff.
Yo,
really I heard bad, and thou shalt not covet.
Oh. Yo,
there it is.
I heard somebody say a different perspective. They said if they hear that a car got broken into, they would say, well, I'm glad the dude that was in need got what he needed.
That's what they, so who says that? I never heard that.
Yo, people who listen know what's up.
That is a very
what are your thoughts?
That is a man of God. I have to say that. Whoever said that, that's
it was no man of God, brother. Is that what you say?
Somebody broke into his car, he's like, well, I got the person in need, got what they needed.
Would you say that?
So thankful for that. Like, I would be upset if somebody stole my stuff, but that's like, I guess, a righteous way of looking at it.
All right, so Jada Pinkett. I'm sorry, guys.
I'd give them the shirt off my back if they wanted to steal it.
Will Smith. So what was Ruslan's take on that?
So he brought it to the word.
Since we don't have one.
No, you're the one that's interested in his take. I don't even know why we're talking about his take.
I want to hear his take.
We should have our own take.
I want to hear his take, and then I want to give my perspective. Go ahead.
So his take was, you know, that Christ never intended for more than one wife or more than anything. He intended it to be the way it was intended for a reason. That is the design.
Mm-hmm.
And every time we step outside of the design, it ends up in a disaster. You know what I'm saying? So that's
so God's way, pretty much. Yeah.
Just
at the end of the day, wrap
stick
it up.
To do it the way God intended it.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And that was pretty much his take. And that when people try to make things like higher than what it actually is. So for an example, when Will Smith and Jada said, we're breaking away from the title marriage and we're partners in a spiritual sense.
Yeah.
It kind of gives it like this luster, like marriage wasn't enough. We're transcended.
Elevated
to this level of
this
consciousness.
New...
And it is a life partnership.
The journey together.
In a spiritual sense.
In a spiritual sense, it's a partnership because it's really just you, being the other person's...
Support system, champion,
it's like
whatever.
Cheerleader.
Embody whatever they want you to embody. You know, you just 100% for that one person. You know, like that's the way they made it seem. Like, we just champion for each other. And that's what we see.
Plus,
we don't see this whole marriage. They painted it out like almost like marriage was a form of bondage, and they freed each other. We freed ourselves from this. We are now life partners. Because I think that the whole husband, wife, you know, the like it almost has like a hierarchy in a sense. Like, this is the husband and this is the wife. So they got rid of the titles. And they are life partners.
Equals.
There's no marriage. There's no husband. There's no wife.
Completely.
It is just
the same type of position. So like two CEOs of a company. Like two individual.
So that's why Ruslan was like hopping in on that. He's like, I typically don't talk about, you know, secular things, but because they try to make it spiritual.
The marriage part of it.
They try to make it spiritual, something higher than what it already is.
So then address
so,
it.
So, you know, he wanted to address it and
dope.
Say, look.
Shout out to Ruslan. That's dope, man. Dope. I think I like that perspective, man. I got nothing to say on it.
Like, honestly, I didn't even think God's way. To go that deep with it.
Yeah, right here, baby. No, you can take it.
You need it because where your phone go?
Yeah, baby. But yeah, man, I think you gotta be super careful when it comes to stuff like that, man. You gotta be anything that's led by just emotions or like when it starts getting like you start like really dabbling with defining certain words and it becomes convoluted. Like it's like all these weird. You're trying to redefine things and reshape things. Like red flags should go up right away, man. Because
well, that's always been my concern. Like I can care less about what people do with their lives. You know what I'm saying? Like if they ask me my opinion,
if it's for you,
then yeah,
if you start adapting to that mentality,
that's what I'm saying.
You know what I'm saying? Like
it's dangerous.
It's very dangerous, bro. Like you really could start. It could start getting to you, and then you kind of justify it with scripture, bro. You try to. We see the weird things that people do with the Bible, bro. Like it's not far-fetched, man.
There's actual churches like, people, where they bring in venomous snakes.
We talked about that before, yeah.
To bite themselves because they have this faith and they're gonna be healed.
There's some crazy stuff that happens out there, bro.
Crazy.
Yo, when you're reading the Bible, dude, you're supposed to read the Bible like any common book, like front and back, chapter by chapter, verse by verse. Understand
who wrote it, the time it was written, who was
it written to. Like it's just like any other book in that aspect on how you study the book.
Facts.
How do you study this book? You open it up.
Like I don't understand it. Like it's a book of spells. Like oh,
like recipes.
Thou shalt
like
not recipes. Pick up thine water. Yo,
remember that thing?
No, that's not a spell, man.
You heard that thing called lucky dipping when they just open up the Bible to any random page
and they just bam,
and they just put your finger. You close your eyes. Oh. You like put your finger in. God wants me to do this.
Must
wait a minute.
The church.
This is about. What do you call them? Man, what do you call that, man?
What?
The dudes that.
The dudes that what?
That. Man.
Eunuch.
Eunuch. Yeah, you lucky dip into eunuch. You're like, hold on. Hold on. You lucky like God, what are you wait a minute.
What are you trying to say, God?
Do you retry? Do you like
oh that's a
it's like a roll
retry.
Of the dice, you're
that's
like
a
no, that was a
and then that's when you start using the Bible, like it's one of the black the eight balls.
Oh, that was the devil.
I rebuke you.
Satan, I rebuke you. Let me try again.
I will receive riches.
Re-roll.
There you go.
You re-roll
God.
That.
Look at God.
Look at God. It says, I'll
receive your riches. Like, oh, look at God, man. See,
when it gets to the blessing that you want, mad selfish, bro.
Solomon receives riches.
Yo,
I knew it.
I
knew it, God.
I was lucky dipping like crazy, and everything I was lucky dipping in, I was like. Wrath. I'm like, oh man.
Dang.
Like all there is wrath for me, man. Like,
and fire and brimstone rained upon. Oh man.
It had to be a sign.
And he fell down to the lake of fire. Oh shoot. I'm in Psalms. What are you talking about, lake of fire?
I'm in Psalms. Oh my goodness. All right. Oh, so what do we got? How much time we got?
How much time we got? We got a minute.
Oh my goodness, man.
So how was your 4th of July, bro?
It was dope, man. Well, first of all, do we celebrate that?
Oh my goodness. Give me a break.
Do we celebrate the 4th of July?
Did 4th of July get canceled? Hello, I don't know.
I thought the 4th of July got canceled, though.
Dang, man. I thought we were celebrating Independence Day. You ain't on Independence Day?
The holiday got canceled. That was like,
that's crazy.
Don't get me with no fireworks.
Don't tell me that we're not woke enough. They're going to be like, see, it's not really Independence Day because you ain't really independent. Think about it.
You see?
Think about it. We press, son.
So I had a gathering.
Had some cheeseburgers.
I had a
non-oppressed ones.
I had a gathering. We had a good time, man. And the kids, man, got to play with each other.
That's
man.
Dope.
Put out the bikes, put out the chalk for the driveway, put out the pool, you know, and took out the little sparkles and all that stuff at night.
I saw the little kissy picture you took with wifey. It was good.
Bro, it was fire, bro.
Better cue.
Yeah, I'm at that age, bro, where I'm looking at them having fun, and that's fun to me.
What was that? Oh, yeah, it's a tradition.
It's a tradition.
According to her. Tradición.
Wifeys always make the tradition.
Yeah, they every year they got to take a picture with the sparklers.
You got to make it sparkle, man.
They got to do it for the gram every year.
I do it for the gram. I ain't going to do it. Nah, I ain't going to do it. That's me all the time, too. I'm like, nah, I ain't going to do that.
And
wifey be yelling at me,
and
do it for
every
the gram.
Year he grabs the sparkler ever so slowly.
I ain't gonna do it for the gram. She's like yelling at me, you gonna do this for the gram.
Next year I look back and y'all like, both dancing like, do it for the gram.
Yeah. No,
I said,
okay,
do it for the gram. Like, wait a minute, what happened?
Oh man, I don't know who that is.
That's gotta be mine. It's gotta have my pops.
So I guess that's it, man. How was yours, man? How was your weekend?
It was dope watching TV, man.
Yeah. Okay. That's all you did?
Pretty much.
Really?
No. We actually tried to salvage the day. It was actually a story.
I thought you had a pool ready.
No, we're still not ready yet, man. Yo, owning a pool is hard. It's hard. Because you got to understand the chemical. No, I don't even going to get it.
Okay.
But yeah, we didn't get to the pool because, you know, trying to figure that out. So we ended up trying to find a grill. Last minute buying. We are typical Puerto Ricans, man. We last minute. So we
went and found a grill.
We got the grill.
And rocks.
And it was already like 3-4 o'clock. Then we realized we need a tank. So now we're driving around trying to find a tank. Every place is sold out.
What do you mean by find or drive it off? Oh, you're going to the stores.
The propane tank.
Okay, I thought you were like
driving around.
I thought you were like looking for grills. Like,
No, we found a grill. We got the grill.
Like your neighbor's grill or something. Like you were driving around like...
You're looking for grills. There's a grill. Let's just go drive
by.
There's
a propane tank.
Take this grill. Let's go. Chicken to
do. You just use it. Imagine you just use
put
it.
Put it back nice and clean.
No, you just cook on it. You just go out there and just like, yo.
Oh my goodness. Imagine somebody come on somebody's house.
Just chilling.
Hey, man. You
hey,
a grill.
What's up, man? Hey. Is this a public grill?
Happy Fourth.
You want a burger?
You want a burger?
I got adobo. Hey, you got ketchup?
So we ended up finding the grill. But then we didn't have a tank. We're like, oh, we ain't gonna be able to do this. So now we're looking around. There's nobody got them. They're sold out. Mm. Come to find out, where they were was literally 2 minutes from my house. We could have just got a tank a long time ago, but we ended up getting a tank. Now it's like 5 o'clock. Now we got to put this thing together. So then we put it together. Now it's getting to like 7. Now we start grilling around 7:30, 8 o'clock. About done by like 9. That's when we had our grilled
man,
4th of July burgers.
Really, bro?
It was awesome. It was great. Great 4th of July. Pew pew.
Yeah.
I wish we had that sound.
Pew 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 pew. Oh, the fan fan.
That would have been dope right now. That would have been dope. That was my 4th, man. It was dope, though. It was, you know, we had a family. I was able to give my wife my famous burgers, you know what I'm saying? I make from scratch. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like, dope. You actually get the beef and everything,
yeah, I get
bro?
The beef, though. Just straight up ground beef. And then I put, like, you know, fresh ingredients, meat, the patties, grill them up.
Should do a cooking
show.
It
came out bomb, bro.
You should do the Gil Vargas cooking show, man.
I'll do that, man. One of these days, we're going to have a Mario Esco live outside. We'll grill up some burgers and I'll show you my recipes,
man. Yeah. That is dope.
It will be dope. But yeah, man, the family loved the burgers. So I lived up to the hype, thank God, because I was like, man, if they like these burgers is trash, I would have been salty because I've been talking about my burgers for a while now. But yeah, other than that, it was dope. You know, we had some good burgers. You know, we talked, chill, had a good time with the fam.
Fire, bro. I was just saying that I'm at that age, bro, where I enjoy just watching the kids enjoy themselves.
For real. It's nice.
Like, that's where I'm at.
I can't. I'm
that's
at why
that age.
That's
I'm
one
just
of the
like,
reasons why I can't wait to get this pool ready. Man.
I'm going too fast.
To see my daughter enjoy the pool and jump
my song. My songs are like,
what do you mean?
I'm like, everything's changing. I'm like feeling like, man, it's like,
you're like the old man with the,
grandpa,
with the guitar.
Man, you
on
know,
the,
like
he's he, on the front porch.
Yo, that ain't a bad playing. Idea. I don't mind that. You see Holmes be playing the guitar, bro.
That's dope.
That's fire,
I envy that.
I would
and I know I shouldn't envy that, but I do. It's dope to just be able just to pick up the guitar.
Just sit there, just jam, just be like, out. Yo, I just want to chill.
That's fire.
Jam out. Yo, I like
and that's
that,
how man. Mario came out with that song, man. He had his harmonica and everything. He's like, with evil up in his crown.
All right, y'all. We're going to jump into this track, and then we out of here, man, until next week. Hope you guys had fun. Hope you guys were blessed. We'll try to do better. We're getting the topics there. Hopefully, you guys had a good laugh and enjoyed yourself. This is...
Or if you want to keep it the same, hit subscribe. Hit yo, comment. Just, and say, subscribe. Keep it the same.
Hit subscribe.
So we don't listen to the comments from our
subscribers. We don't listen to...
Hey, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell so you get reminded whenever we post anything new. Yeah.
And every now and then I'll comment to those people that are like, I thought this was Christian. I rebuke you guys. But
I almost thought you said this is chicken.
I thought this was chicken.
This was this not is
Julieta,
chicken.
Was it?
This is Julieta. That's the name of the song. Not chicken, Julieta. That's it.
Not chicken, Julieta. All right, y'all. Here's one. Hold up, I gotta write that, bro. Not chicken, Julieta. You better remember that.
I do.
Here's 116 featuring Lecrae, Paris Charisse, Big Wave.
Charisse.
So next week, we love y'all. Keep us lifted. Keep us in prayer. We really love y'all. We enjoy the time, man.
Yeah,
we look forward to our Wednesdays, and just chop it up. Whatever, man. It's cool.
I love it.
So we'll see you next Wednesday, Lord willing. Grace and peace. Be blessed.
Let me talk. Big pun talk on the line, you just hold me down. Big dog beat, take it home, gotta give it to the pound. Yeah, light on my chest and my back, try to take me out. Hey, big wave dripping on stage, make the whole crowd drown. Big wave dripping on stage. Big dog, let me out the cage. Big wave dripping on stage, make the whole crowd drown. I just got told it's my season. Right. Remember when I was on defense? Uh-huh. God took me out of the deep end. Wow. If you wanted, it's better to speak it. Right. I'ma cough and get back to the treatment. Ooh. I'm a soldier, my father the kingpin. You got problems if I'm in a sequence. Right. It's the master, just follow the teaching. I've been working, my nights have been sleepless. Say my name if you want it, you keep it. If it's peak, gotta make sure we eat it. Almost quit, I got labeled a heathen. God works on my faith, they been peaking. 45 till I die, are you dreaming? All these blessings ain't wanted, it's needed. Come get the ropes from me. Uh-huh. No, the plan is like old to me. Uh-huh. Full of stroke is choking me. Uh-huh. I'm where I'm supposed to be. Big plug talk on the line, you hold me down. Big dog beat, take it home, gotta give it to the pound. Yeah, light on my chest and my back, try to take me out. Hey, big wave dripping on stage, make the whole crowd drown.
Yeah, big wave, big chain, big drip, drowning. 10 band, maintain, tap dance, clowning. They don't even know they shook. They don't even know they stuck. They don't really know the business. They just want Bentley trucks, put a bow in a leader. They just wanna roll they weed up. I just bought a stove tryna re up. I just wanna tell folk read up. We got the chemistry. Why we give into this industry? Selling this murderous ministry. What we intend to be. Nipsey was giving us energy. They got not what they pretend to be. Big splash, skip class, get cash, blow that. Post schools, no tools, we lose. Hold that, I got partners that steal trap. Free my dogs in the steel traps. Drip too small, we don't feel that, it's real rap.
Let me talk, big plug talk on the line, you just hold me down. Big dog beat, take it home, gotta give it to the pound. Yeah, light on my chest and my back, try to take me out. Hey, big wave dripping on stage, make the whole crowd drown. Big wave dripping on stage, big dog, let me out the cage. Big wave dripping on stage, make the whole crowd drown. Big wave dripping on stage. Big dog, let me out the cage. Okay. Big wave dripping on stage, make the whole crowd drown.
If you're listening on the podcast, be sure to check out my Facebook music page, Mario Esco 1. Again, two R's in my name, the number one at the end, Mario Esco 1. Be sure to like and follow that page because I like to give updates on who I'll be interviewing and leave a description on what we'll be talking about. And I also like the real-time, one-on-one, back-and-forth interaction. If you don't have the time to join us on Facebook Live, be sure to check out my podcast. It's called Mario Esco Live, two R's in my name. Again, you'll see the white silhouette of myself with the cross.
Lost in the Need. Be sure to subscribe to that and follow the link as well to whatever podcast you're using or however you're receiving the podcast, and leave us a review. We love to hear feedback. You can also hit me up at music@marioesco.com and just hit me up with some feedback and ways that we can improve the show or the things that you like and enjoy. Any type of feedback will be highly appreciated. Grace and peace.